Hello, my name is Nitin. Today, we are looking a bit closer into SPIAC's latest cDASY6 release, namely cDASY6 version 6.14. This version was released in response to several customer inputs regarding the fact that non-optimal grid settings of the zoom scan either requires re-measurements or increases the measurement time for all zoom scans. Version 6.14 therefore includes an automated mode that optimizes the zoom scan automatically based on a pre-scan. This is pretty clever as it saves up to 30% of overall project measurement time by ensuring that zoom scans do not need to be remeasured. In the next few minutes, I will demonstrate how in the new release, the zoom scan resolution settings are optimized for transmitting devices such as this phone here so that it meets all grid requirements defined by the uncertainty budget provided by SPIAC as well as the new IEC amendment. The 6.14 release features two possibilities for zoom scan settings, a user definition and a smart mode. The user definition mode allows the user to define custom grid settings and offsets. Warnings are provided in case the grid step settings in the user definition mode are larger than SPIAC's recommendations. SPIAC's recommendations are available under the Preferences tab and they define the minimal grid settings as a function of frequency. The recommended grids are compliant with all the standards of IEC, IEEE and FCC, except in case of very localized exposures when the new requirement of the IEC standard amendment needs to be applied. If this is the case, the zoom scan needs to be remeasured with a finer grid. We always avoided to override recommended grids by SPIAC as it would have required to perform our own uncertainty study, a very challenging task. The cool new feature of this release is the smart zoom scan setting mode. In this mode, the software undertakes a fine resolution pre-scan before the zoom scan. This pre-scan information is then used to dynamically decide the optimum grid settings for the succeeding zoom scan that is minimal to meet the uncertainty budget requirements and avoid the risks of having to remeasure the zoom scan. Next, I will demonstrate the two different modes for this test device. This phone has an antenna in the bottom edge which generates a sharp specific absorption rate distribution at LTE 1950 MHz. First, we will test this device in the user definition mode with the standard settings typically used for frequencies less than 3 GHz. That is, a zoom scan cube of 30 × 30 × 30 mm with a 6 × 6 × 5 mm grid spacing. For demonstration purposes, we ignore the manufacturer grid warning for the moment. I accelerate the video. The scan is now finished. As the SAR distribution is sharp, the software generated a warning for the 3 dB radius criterion from the IEC 62209-2-2019 amendment. In a normal compliance scenario, this would require a retest of the device with the newly recommended grid resolutions. Let us now measure the same device in the smart mode. After the area scan is completed, the software now undertakes a finer resolution pre-scan centered to the location of the maximum found from the area scan. The pre-scan results are used to ascertain the 3 dB radius and then optimize the zoom scan grid settings accordingly. The measurement is now finished, and as we look at the zoom scan grid settings, the XY resolutions for this zoom scan have been optimized to 4.2 and 4.2 mm respectively. The new zoom scan no longer shows any 3 dB or M2 by M1 warning and therefore meets the requirements of the IEC 62209-2 2019 amendment. The user therefore does not have to repeat the scans anymore. Measurements on several similar devices and antennae have revealed that the new smart zoom scan feature in cDASY6 version 6.14 works really well and results in substantial savings in time and cost. This is particularly important for modern devices which are getting thinner, have antennas in closer proximity to the phantom and generate sharper distributions. This new release is an important step towards quick, accurate and repeatable measurements for these modern devices. In general, it saves for measuring all six sites in touch about 30% in time, and most importantly, warranties results within the uncertainty budget. Thank you for watching this video.